key constituency. About 69 million millennials, 50% of them voted in 2008. That dropped a little bit in 2012. Motivating younger voters to turn out and vote, absolutely critical for Secretary Clinton. If you look at the numbers, the latest numbers we have, you would say Houston or Brooklyn, I guess in this case, we've got a problem. This is the CBS New York Times recent poll, the most recent national poll. Now, these are voters under 30. Millennials go up in 2016, 18 to 35 is the millennial generation. But among voters under 30, 38%, 22 for Trump, 26 for Johnson, 10% for Stein. 36% of voters under 30 are going for the third party candidates. Now, Clinton leads, so you could say, what's the problem? President Obama got about roughly ballpark 60% of this vote. 60%. She's getting less than 40. Simple math. The closest state in 2012 was the state of Florida. You look at our new numbers there. Again, these are voters under 45. Millennials would be voters under 35. But Clinton's ahead, yes. But again, some bleed to the third party candidates, and Trump actually doing pretty well with younger voters. If this persists into Election Day, and Hillary Clinton is winning millennials, but not by a big margin, and they're not turning out in big numbers, that's a problem. One of the issues when you look at the millennial voters is they are clearly not invested in politics. They've only voted once, maybe twice. Maybe they identify more as Democrats, but they have big appeal right now to looking at the Libertarians, looking at the Green Party candidates. Motivating them is challenge number one, and then keeping them in the Democratic fold for Hillary Clinton, challenge number two. Number three is watch Gary Johnson. If he makes the first debate, could be a problem for Secretary Clinton with those younger voters because they're looking around. They're looking for something different.